the RNZAF station at Lathala Bay, Fiji, Air Vice Marshal Neville, Chief of Air Staff, Inspector Guard of Honor. He is here to take part in the defense talks which the New Zealand Chiefs of Staff are holding with the Governor of Fiji. The talks begin next day at Government House, and with the Governor, Sir Brian Freeston, is Major General Sir Norman Weir, Chief of New Zealand Army, Commodore Simpson, Chief of Naval Staff, and Air Vice Marshal Neville. On account of Fiji's strategic position, its defence is of vital importance to New Zealand, and the future role of the RNZAF station near Suva is a matter for discussion in these talks. This station is at present an air sea rescue base for airlines operating in and out of Fiji. Spectators get a closer look at some of New Zealand's best dogs taking part in the South Island and New Zealand Sheepdog Championships at North Tairi, near Dunedin. There's a record entry and an appropriately big crowd. An added attraction is some judging on points. Smooth, rough and bearded collies are all represented. And over here, the crowd are doing some judging of their own. It's the final of the head, pull and yard championship. The dog has just 12 minutes to get the sheep down the 600 yards from the hilltop and into the yard itself. The dog's owner must stay inside the one chain ring encircling the yard. The gate may not be opened until the sheep have entered the ring. From now on, the competitor faces disqualification if he comes in front of the line of the gate. The dog's name is Bonnie, owned by Alec Matheson of Middlemarch. Mr. Matheson has already held a New Zealand championship. This is the stage when it's all the competitor can do to keep behind that gate. Time's running out, and the sheep are almost in the pen. But to rush them now might spoil everything. The dog's superb intelligence and years of experience are being put to their biggest test. They're in. And to Alec Matheson and Bonnie goes this year's New Zealand championship. By month, ships cross the Pacific bringing immigrants, visitors and returning New Zealanders. One returning Kiwi is Tony Rex of Auckland. A member of the Kiwi Concert Party since the desert days of 1941, he's just back from a year in London, where he studied music on a rehab overseas bursary. This time, Tony's stay in New Zealand is only to be a short one.
My plans are to fly to Melbourne to rejoin the Kiwis, where I left them in 1946. And they're still playing there at the Comedy Theatre. As a matter of fact, they recently broke the Australasian record for the number of consecutive performances by the one company in the same theatre. I think the Kiwis are keen to tour New Zealand again, but they have had such a successful season in Australia that I think they're finding it difficult to come away. A song that was very popular in the desert was Lindy Lou. Lindy, did you hear that mockingbird sing last night? Honey, he was singing so sweet in the moonlight. In the old magnolia tree, blasting his heart with a melody. I know he was singing of you, my Lindy Lou, Lindy Lou. Like that bird sings to you, my little Lindy Lou. Lindy, did you feel that soft wind blow last night? Honey, he was kissing you soft in the moonlight. Blowing from the old bayou, seemed to say he so, my honey, that's the way I love you, my Lindy Lou, Lindy Lou. I'd lay right down and die, if I could be that wind a-kissing you, my little.
miles from Christchurch on Banks Peninsula is romantic Akaraa, Canterbury's oldest settlement. The colourful history of this favourite resort is belied by the sleepy look Akaraa wears out of season. Whaling tripods on the foreshore recall the whalers of many nationalities who made the landlocked harbour their base in the early 19th century. Some of these old houses are now abandoned and overgrown. Others have been put to more lowly uses. But many are still treasured as dwellings with a dignity and character of their own. In them lived the French immigrants who sailed to Akaraa, hoping to claim the South Island as a French possession. They arrived too late, but they stayed on. This was the house of Commodore Laveaux, captain of the frigate which escorted the immigrant ship. His is still an everyday name here. So are those of many others of his countrymen. And in the French cemetery on Loeb Hill, French and British share a common memorial. Reminders of the past are everywhere. An old shop. The brickworks from which the materials for many of the early houses came. Soda from this old French siphon must have topped up many a drink in days gone by. Here lived the first miller in Canterbury, who ground wheat sent from all parts of the province. His place later became Canterbury's first brewery. The fruit and walnut trees imported by the French provide a present-day industry. Fine fat stock are raised on the hills overlooking the harbour and the bays. While the Christchurch market is kept regularly supplied by the Akaraa trawler fleet, which operates the year-round in the harbour and the fishing grounds beyond its entrance. The industry for which Akaraa is most widely known, however, is the manufacture of tweeds. For years, Akaraa tweeds have held a high place throughout New Zealand. Today, the factory is kept at full pressure, attempting to meet demands. Tweeds of many different patterns are turned out at the factory, and experiments with varying colour combinations are constantly being carried out. An abundant water supply and other favourable factors make Akaraa a particularly suitable location for this industry. After cleaning and finishing, the completed cloth is wound into bolts for dispatch to all parts of the country. And from all parts of the country, tourists come here to keep the many hotels and guest houses busy throughout the season. While making the most of her connections with the past, Akaraa has adapted herself and her industries to keep up with the times.